called a Veterans Day Confession for America. And in fact, it's written for all of you and us. On this Veterans Day, let us confess our sins before God and neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and what we have left undone. We have become people of the lie, out to tame the frontier wilderness, while the beast within lurks hidden in shadow, paralyzing us in a perpetual state of denial. We have made war entertainment, enjoying box seats in the carnival of death, consuming violence, turning tragedy into games, raising our children to kill without remorse. We have morally disengaged, outsourcing our killing to the 1%, forgetting they follow our orders. The blood they shed is on our hands too. We have insulated ourselves from the painful truths veterans carry. Our bumper magnets proclaim, support our troops. But for too many, suicide is the only panacea. Our insulation is their isolation. We have made our veterans into false idols, blood sacrifice on the national altar of war. Parades and medals perpetuate the hero myth, glorifying those who kill and die on our behalf. We have betrayed the dead, saying they will never be forgotten. Yet how many among us can name a single war casualty of the past decade? We have sanitized killing and condoned extrajudicial assassinations, death by remote control, war made easy without due process, protecting ourselves from the human cost. We have deceived ourselves, saying Americans do not kill civilians, terrorists do, denying the colossal misery our wars inflict on the innocent. The national closet bursts with skeletons. And we have abandoned our Afghan allies, luring them in with promises of safety and security, then failing to follow through with promises made, using them and leaving them to an almost certain death. Almighty God, on this Veterans Day, help us turn from this wayward path. Deliver us from indifference, callousness, and self-deception. Fill us with compassion for all who bear the burdens of our wars. Grant us the courage to pay attention, to stay engaged, so we may listen without judgment, restore integrity, accept responsibility, keep promises, and give honor to whomever honor is due. I performed more than 60 religious services, counseled hundreds of soldiers. Helped put 18 caskets on a plane as part of dignified transfer ceremonies. And probably 25% of those were deaths by suicide. So one of the realities that became very evident to me was what we are now calling moral injury. Mm-hmm. And a moral injury has been defined well in several books. It's a betrayal of what's right. So in the context of this workshop, talking about the lives of soldiers and service members, and to the extent that drones can save those lives, I can only speak from my personal experience and the kind of moral anguish that I experienced during my 21 weeks living under drones, seeing them launch and land, most of them unarmed, but many of them armed, and seeing them leave with Hellfire missiles and come back without them, and wondering where they landed and who they killed. And our soldiers and service members are connected to the internet and are very aware of reports that are made public. And I know that even for myself, I read the report from Stanford University and the New York University Law School. It came out online, Living Under Drones. It was released the month I arrived in theater. So I'm wrestling with that information and the reality of being on the ground. And that is a soul wound. And that is a moral injury.